Hello, everybody. I'm Jonathan Coachman, and this is Super Bowl Sunday on EA Sports. Up next, we've got a good one on tap between the visiting Houston Texans and the Detroit Lions. Kickoff now just moments away. It is finally time to crown a champion, as I'll hand it over to the two men who will call the action. Brandon Gotten.
All right, much appreciated, Coach, as we welcome all of you to our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy. This will be fielded at the 6. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. First down, it's Watson being chased out left. Once more, the juke. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Back to throw, Watson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Griffin, and he's brought down. 16 yards on that one, and also a Texan first down.
But this offense can get their tight ends involved. They can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
Now it's Watson, flushed out right. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on his first drive. Instead, second down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Oh, and he'll just get rid of this one. Shit!
And that's interesting.
With a first touchdown of the Super Bowl, and along with that, and the Texans have taken the early lead. And we have seen the first touchdown of Super Bowl 52. The first 51 Super Bowls, the team that scored first, they won 34 times out of 51. So two-thirds of the time, but just gaining that momentum's got to be huge in this game.
It's massive, and that's what everyone's looking for. The first big break of a game, the first advantage of the game, and that too, that tends to carry a team, right? Most of the time, you're able to sail on that for a while. And that's what you're looking for. The first touchdown, you're in great shape.
A drive there of just 4 plays. And it results in the Texans finding the end zone. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. On the return, Dwayne Washington. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Stafford and the Lions now have it first and 10 at the 20. Stafford on first down. And a tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. That goes for a gain of 31.
Most receivers love running the post pattern. You go downfield as fast as you can, give a head fake or two, and then you head towards the post in the middle of the field and look for the football. A tough round to cover if you get fooled with a little bit of fake in the middle of it.
So one quarter down here in the Super Bowl. 7-0 is our score, and they've got it here with a first down.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On second down, here's Stafford. Looking for Tate, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 21. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
Well, when someone other than the quarterback is throwing the football, it's either beautiful or a disaster, and here it was the latter.
Nowhere in between, right?
I think you're exactly right. It takes a fortitude to call that technical play, but when it doesn't work, oh boy, you wish you hadn't.
And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. A pickup of 11 at a Texans first down.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And that play is able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
Now a first down throw, Watson. That's complete over the middle to Anderson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Texans passing game in rhythm right now, picking up another first.
Gardner's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because for the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball as we just saw there.
The completion good for 3 minutes, second down. He was out there waving his arms. When you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. On first down, Watson. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It's a 4-yard pickup, and it's second down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Here's Watson. And he's got it. And he's brought down. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl. So the halftime show of the Super Bowl, abbreviated, ready to go for the second half. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in the Super Bowl. This feeling at the two. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Here comes Matthew Stafford now to lead his offense back out there. And he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say, well, get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, at halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little, kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter. On first down, O'Doolin. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
And that's another stop for the defense, something we've seen all game long. They've been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
To throw to Stafford. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 12.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Throwing on 3rd down, Stafford. And he locates Luke Nelson. And he'll be taken down across the 50 and the 45 in enemy territory. Stafford and the former Seahawk, Wilson for Lions first.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work. And that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Lions trailing, but with possession of the football as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter. On first Stafford here.
And on the left side here, Wilson. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Stafford gives it to Gula on the ground. Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Back to throw. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 49. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. Scoring has really been at a premium. It shows you got to tip your cap to this defense coming in here. Their offense, too, but this whole team coming in here on the road, getting a hard-fought win.
I think the way that they're finishing this one up, an exclamation point on a terrific game. As you noted, hard for them to put points on the board, and they hold them down one more time and finalize things.
And the Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Throwing now, Watson. And this one is incomplete.
Sometimes we wonder about play calls, but this one made perfect sense to me. He's got the only touchdown that they've scored in this game. Tried to get it to him again on another deep ball.
Now Watson. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. And we're going to get another timeout called by the Lions. As they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now it's Watson.
And blocked down, but not before
he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. As they stop it here with a minute 7 remaining. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Watson. And a great score here in this one. And that touchdown just might do it.
I would agree. That probably does. Barring a miracle, they're in great shape.
Now comes the kicking team here for the extra point. Fairbairn going with the extra point. And it's now 14-0. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Jamal Agnew now to return it. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it out past the 30. And Detroit getting set to go now. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, trying to get them set up down a little bit.
And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue, and that'll be incomplete. From the 50, it's Stafford. Oh, it's Stafford, a football, and he's going to come down with it. 19 yards that time for number 19. Counting down at 30 seconds remaining. And he clocks it with just over 30 seconds left. To the air again, Stafford. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down. Hard to believe his first catch of the game defensively. They bottled him up. That's why they're well on their way to victory.
Put your best cover guy on him and then change the coverages behind him throughout the game. Brackets, double, zone, man, you name it. Make sure he gets a lot of angles.
They're able to locate 4 yards there. This methodical drive continues.
And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
Stafford looks to throw again. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. And the Lone Star State has a new champion. It's the Houston Texans, kings of the Super Bowl. And to the Super Bowl champions, they etch their name forever in NFL immortality.
That's pretty phenomenal right there. It actually gave me chills just to hear you say that, because immortality forever and ever. When you look in the record books, you'll see this team, you'll see their picture, that your name will be a part of it. That's got to be an incredible feeling, because it's been a long journey to get there, and now they get a chance to enjoy it.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. It feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gunn signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.